Hey, I'm Danny with Amigo the Devil, and you're watching Tattoo.com.
Hey, everybody, it's Mischievous Mel live and presented with Amigo the Devil. That's right, I'm standing here next to the creator of acoustic comedy Devil Rock.
I like that.
I practiced that just because, not that I didn't want to say it all at once, but sometimes it comes out of my mouth like balls on your tongue, and it just gets all caught in there, so yeah.
Like after a whole day or before, just fresh out the shower?
Fresh out of the shower balls are the best, but we're talking probably the end of the day balls.
Couple sets, couple days into tour, no showers, that kind of balls.
The kind when you take off your ruse and it goes crunch. Now that we've done that, now that I've introduced, I love this. So you, now that I've explained that, you got to explain to people that have not seen your perform. It's not a show; it's a performance.
Well, thank you for that. It's it took a lot of figuring out to do. I was just kind of terrified with the whole acoustic thing when I started, and I didn't know what to do, and then I realized people started interacting, and I was like, oh shit, I should probably interact back, and then they kind of turned into this whole just existing and messing up with people and laughing, and it's a big old just hangout now.
See, I totally feel like if I was at a coffee shop and they said acoustic music, I would want it to be you, and not that bitch that sings about flowers. Not that I don't like flowers, I do bees, but you know what I'm saying?
I like flowers too, though. I like flowers too, though. There's a time and a place.
Favorite flower?
I don't know any.
Ah, you see what I did there? I fucked with him. I was like the devil. Right?
Do I know any flowers? I mean, I know flowers.
Let's go with sunflowers.
Sunflower.
See, I helped him out there because I'm not that.
Sunflower.
But there's like, well, there's no sun yet. So what are the chances?
Skyflower.
What are the chances of your guy, the devil, making it rain today?
Probably pretty high.
Right.
I'm kind of a bummer.
Right? Because Mother Nature is a fucking whore.
I hope it's right after our set, though, so everyone else gets screwed over and we get to do our thing. And then everyone else is just like, oh, shit. Sorry.
I love the fucking honesty there. That was awesome. Like, fuck you. It didn't fuck me. It didn't affect me.
Wait till 3:45-ish.
That's awesome, though. That is the best fucking answer I have ever heard. Like, fuck you, I'm out. I got my shit.
Usually that's how it works.
Well, you know, and to be fair, this is a new experience.
I can't believe how big all the grounds are and all that. We haven't even made it, I guess. We've only seen half of it. It's insane. I don't know how they got this together. I don't know how they got any of them together, to be honest. But
I know the organization. I can't find my car in the Walmart parking lot, exactly. So this is fucked up.
Yeah.
So now, when you do your stuff, you obviously write your own material. What is your influence, because you know it's adorable.
Thank you. I think a lot of it starts with I try to start with an emotion, just a basic human emotion like jealousy, for example, and then I'll try to write a story around the jealousy, and then I'll try to make the story related to something completely different than the story itself, so it has a dual layer kind of situation. So that people who are sad can be sad to it, and people who are not sad can be like, oh, well, I get it.
So like dueling banjos.
Exactly. Right? Exactly. That's where the banjo comes in. Which I still can't play that. I can play like the intro part, but when it picks up, I still can't. I'm not the best banjo player.
I can play spoons, but I can't keep a beat. So what the fuck does that say?
Two peas in a pod.
So if you ever need a guest, you know, I'll spoon for you.
I was gonna say, we can start a band.
Well, there you go.
It's not a good one, but we'll start one.
All right, then. See how he called me out there? Fuck yeah, I would too. I think, I know you don't do covers, but I think if you ever did cartoon theme songs.
That'd be a lot of fun. Yep. I haven't done any cartoon theme songs. I've only done a few covers, like Townes Van Zandt, Hank Williams, and then like Genuine, and I Got Five on it, and songs that I shouldn't be playing.
You should probably do the Thunder Buddy song, too, acoustically.
That'd be a fun one.
That would be fucking epic.
Maybe I'll just try it for fun today.
Do it! Like, do it!
Just wing it. And everyone's like, yeah, you can stop that now, dude.
It's only 15 to 30 seconds. Any woman or man can suffer through 15 or 30 seconds.
And many have.
All right. Now that we've gone everywhere except for music, let's go to something that we should be talking about as well, because we are here also with Tattoo.com. I see you have some color on you, sir.
Unfortunately.
Ooh.
Unfortunately.
Let's hear the stories.
I just started too young. I started way too young, and I got ahead of myself, and I didn't really know to appreciate the art at that time. So by the time I knew enough artists that I wanted to get tattooed by, I was already kind of covered in crap.
So were you that dude that were like, yo, you've been like tanning for a week in your mom's basement, I'm fucking in?
I was more so like, yes, but with my friends. I was the guinea pig for all my friends.
Okay. Dude, if this was your friend, you fucking owe him some shit for that, because that's like, you know, that's kind of like, that's like buying somebody off the internet and just, you know, giving them their green card to stay with you because you like them on the internet. And yeah. Then you get them home and it's really a dude in a skirt.
And you're like, well, here you are.
Right?
Let's roll with it.
Kind of. But fortunately, that's less permanent than your ink.
Yeah. It's still fun. I mean, it's funny because a lot of the friends that started out with a lot of the worst tattoos I have are now some of the best tattoo artists I know. And now I'm really jealous when I see their work. I'm like, come on, dude, really?
That's like, when you pull this card on them. You practice on me, motherfucker. You fix this shit right now. And no, I ain't paying nothing. And I want a roofie with that and a stick to bite on.
That's where we're at now, is the cover-up phase. Now we're just doing all the... I mean, we're on like 3-4 layers of cover-ups now. So.
That's gotta be painful as fuck, man.
It sucks.
That's like going through raw hamburger after it's crusted over.
It's the worst. But, meh.
Do you want to show us some, or do you just want to go with they suck?
I mean, they're not. I got like a lot of the horror movie stuff that I got is.
Is that a gremlin I see? Yeah. Oh!
There's a lot of horror movie stuff. I got the Dead Alive. Sleepaway Camp, Bat Boy, that, Cannibal Holocaust, what else? Sleepaway Camp, oh, Cheerleader Camp. I already said Sleepaway Camp. Then up here is like Land Before Time, little dinosaur movie.
That's fucking awesome. Except I do know that movie.
It's all the dinosaurs and they're crying and it says God doesn't believe in us.
Sorry, Jesus lovers.
And then on this one, it's. Jesus listening to like an iPod, and it says God's not listening. There's a lot of those. I don't know why, but
there they are. That's kind of cool. Can I see that one?
Oh yeah.
Din 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 din. Good job. Check.
Is it that one? Yeah, this one.
See, I don't have my. Oh. Oh. You know, actually, there's more truth in that than anything I've seen lately. Yeah, in real life.
A little party dog. Toxic Avenger. This is some of the cover-up crap we're doing. This is my first one, the watch.
That's awesome. And you did the piercing, too. That was taking it a step over the lines there, sir.
Yeah, luckily it stayed. It's been like 12 years.
I was going to ask, how does that work? Because I always toyed with the idea of like bedazzling my shit, but then I'm like, hey.
So I had like 9 of them around, and they all got ripped out or rejected. That's the only one that stayed. It's been about 11, 12 years.
Did the other ones like turn green and crusty, and then you could like press your arm and they'd shoot out like a fucking firecracker?
No, luckily no. It they just turned black and festered, and just I didn't have to press anything. It just oozed on its own.
I love ooze. Okay, so you got like horror movie ones. You need to get, since they're like cult horror movies, you need to get zombie beaver, what, remember?
Oh,
that
zombievers.
Have you seen that?
I love zombievers. It's a good one.
I was like, what the fuck am I watching? And it wasn't that it was good, but I'd already invested 5 minutes into it, so I had to finish watching it.
That's amazing.
And the fact that I know that. So anywho, I have stripped them, we have talked sex music, rock and roll, and
balls.
Yes, that was the first one. And be excited, because maybe you can book them at a coffee shop near you.
I'll play. Please.
With your balls. What?